What is this, Smallji? Sit.
Ma, I am Smallji, which is known as acceleration due to gravity.
Okay, gravity I have heard. But what is this Big G and Smallji, my son?
There is a difference between Smallji and Big G. Big G is the universal gravitational constant, whereas Smallji is the acceleration due to gravity, which is defined as the uniform acceleration produced in a freely falling body due to the gravitational force of the Earth.
Okay, I know that gravitation pulls everything towards the Earth. But what is this free falling?
This is very interesting. I came to know from my science chapter on gravitation that when an object falls from a height towards the Earth under the influence of gravitational force, it is known as free fall or freely falling body.
Okay, so this is the experiment that Galileo was doing from the Leaning Tower of Pisa in Italy, right?
Exactly so, Ma. Galileo had observed that when two stones of different masses were dropped from the top of the Leaning Tower of Pisa, they hit the ground at the same time.
Okay, so basically he was trying to say that the acceleration of the free falling body does not depend on the mass of the object. Is it so?
Yes, Ma. Do you know small g and big g have a value?
Is it so?
Yes, Ma. Small g is taken as 9% meter per second square. Big g is universal gravitational constant and its value is 6.7 into 10 to the power minus 11 newton meter square per kg square.
Okay, so both have a value. But still I am a bit confused. Big G, small g, can you explain a bit more?
Okay, let me explain to you with the Newton's gravitational force of attraction between two objects.
Okay.
Action. See, Ma, as per Newton's law of gravitational force of attraction, force is equal to big G into mass 2 by mass 2 into mass 1 into mass 2 by R square. It is equation 1. Another way you can see the force of attraction between these two objects is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Where big G's value you can see 6.7 into 10 to the power minus 11 newton meter square per kg square. Now you can see the force of attraction put by the Earth on free falling body or object is given by force is equal to mass 1 into small g, it is equation 2. Now we can equate equation 1 and equation 2. Mass 1 is equal to small g is equal to big g into mass 1 into mass 2 by r square. Now you can see mass 1 and mass 1 are common. By cutting mass 1 and mass 1, you get small g is equal to big g into mass 2 by r square. Big g into mass 2 is mass of the Earth and r square is radius of the Earth. Small g is equal to 6 per... Now by putting the respective value of mass of the Earth and radius of the Earth, we get 9.10 meter per second square.
So now you have proven very well that the value of small g has a constant value, just as the value of big G has a constant value. But what is so great about the value of small g when both are constant?
No, Ma. The value of small g is 9.8 meters per second square when the shape of the Earth is spherical, but our Earth is not spherical in shape.
Okay, so I understand that we need to understand the place determining value of small g. Can you explain this to me?
Then wait a minute. Let me try to recall where else I have seen the value of small g. Oh yeah, Eureka! I remembered that the time period of simple pendulum is please dependent on small g, and I came to know this while doing experiment with Subhashankar.
Okay, so you did the experiment with Subhashankar. So now can you do the experiment again? What do you need for that?
Well, Ma, I don't need special items. I need only string or thread, a small bulb, a stopwatch which is already available in our smart mobile phone and a scale.
Okay, these items are all available here. You can have them, they are all there. So you can do this experiment on simple pendulum.
Thank you, Ma. Let me set up the experiment. Before that, I will explain it in theory.
Okay.
Let me set up the experiment to determine the value of small g at our place, that is Shillong. The time period of simple pendulum, which includes small g, is given by p is equal to 2 pi root l by g. It is equation 1. And you can see where t is time period in seconds, l is length of thread in meter, g is acceleration due to gravity. Now to determine the value of small g, let us bring this at left hand side of equation. After squaring both sides, t square is equal to 4 pi square l by g. It is equation 2. Now small g is equal to 4 pi square l by t square. It is equation 3. Now for doing experiment, let us take length of thread l is equal to 1 meter. For the purpose of simplification, then calculate the time of 20 pendulum oscillations. Now let us do the experiment outside. This thread is 1 meter and we have measured the length of this thread with the help of the scale. Now I will stretch it at a certain height and I will leave it without applying any force.
Now we will take the reading of 20 oscillations. Start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Stop. So what is the reading?
Now the reading has come 39.24 seconds.
Okay, for 20 oscillations.
For 20 oscillations.
Thank you. So such 5 readings you can take for each 20 oscillations and record the time taken,
by
20 oscillations. Thank you.
Dima, now we have taken 5 readings. Number first is 39.24 second. Number second is 39.62 second. Number third is 40.01 second. Number fourth is 40.41 second. Number fifth is 39.38 seconds. By taking the calculation, now you can see the calculation, we took the average of these 5 readings and so the time period of one oscillation, t is equal to 1.9905 seconds. Now small g is equal to 4 pi square l by t square equal to 4 into 3.14 square into 1 by 1.9905 square meter per second square. Now by simplifying the value, we get 9.953 meter per second square, which is at Shillong.
Wow, it's fantastic to know the value of small g here at Shillong. I'm sure with this experiment, which is such a simple one with ordinary materials available at home, many learners like you will be able to know the value of small g of their own place, isn't it?
Yes, Ma. It is very enjoyable to know the value of small g at our place, that is Shillong. That is why I was telling A, G, E, O, G, Lo, G, Su, Do, G, I, S, Ball, G, I, S, Ball, G,
A, G, O, G, Lo, G, Su, Do, G, I, S, Ball, G, I, S, Ball, G.